took an action to Christchurch. That one's gone the A35 Barrett Road, all open again westbound. On the train, Eurostar services suspended between London and Brussels because of industrial action, and Eurocar has a waiting time of up to 2 hours for passenger services after technical problem was resolved. That's a more than half an hour.
Well, resolved then. Martin Brandt from Burnley says, please give my love to Denise Hardy, my beautiful girlfriend. She woke me up this morning because I was crying.
How many fights last night?
The only excuse for that kind of noise.
Shaking wall.
Maybe it was all too much. Too much for a man to take. Everything's gone to break. Come on in. You're all that I can show. Hating.
Suspicion of murder in Claudia Laurel. The 35-year-old chef's disappearance has baffled people for more than 6 years. One theory is that she has gone missing as she walked to work at York University in March 2009. North Yorkshire Police are urging people to show restraint and not publicly name any of the men who have been arrested.
Shares in Tesco have risen by 2.5% after it reported a pre-tax loss of £6.3 billion. That's the worst result in its history. The market response is in anticipation that the supermarket giant will now start to improve. French police have arrested a man suspected of planning to attack churches. The Interior Minister, Bernard Cazeneuve, said the 24-year-old has also been questioned about the murder of a young woman. He was detained after apparently accidentally shooting himself. Lucy Williamson reports from Paris.
Mr. Cazeneuve said police had found an arsenal of weapons at the home of the young suspect, including handguns, ammunition and bulletproof vests. Documents found there, he said, proved beyond doubt the man was planning imminent attacks against one or two churches in France. He's also implicated in the murder of a 32-year-old woman, Aurélie Chatelain, found dead in her car in the capital on Sunday morning. Ms. Chatelain had arrived in the Paris region from her home in northern France to take part in professional training. The Mayor of London has suggested that the SAS should be sent to Libya to lead European efforts to tackle human traffickers. In an interview with Boris Johnson, suggesting it's needed to deal with the ruthless smugglers sending people to their deaths in the Mediterranean. The British Deputy Defence Minister said his country's coast guards are being overwhelmed and need more boats and helicopters to save refugee lines. He's called on northern European countries to do more. The US leaders are meeting tomorrow to consider the crisis. The Liberal Democrats say they want public sector workers protected from pay cuts in the next parliament. Their education spokesman David Laws explained the reason.
One is a basic issue of fairness for public sector workers. They've had a squeeze on their pay for a prolonged period now. We believe that should come to an end. But the other thing is that because we're now seeing private sector pay begin to lift off, we are increasingly at risk of having recruitment problems in the public services if we don't set public sector pay at a competitive level.
Massive storm back in southeastern Australia has struck Newcastle, the world's largest port exporting coal. The storm has cost millions of
When they visit, the volume on the TV went from 16 to 40 hours, cover the noise of the store. This did sound. My husband and I have two sleepless nights. In question after highway complete clear, the driver was, dear Flux, get into a motorbike shop.
The motorbike shop?
The motorbike, dear Flux, my motorbike. Dog, is it the dog or the daughter? That snore still loud.
Yeah, I think it's the dog.
I think it's both, actually. If he didn't go up to 16 to 40 hours, that's glorious stay upon its own.
Accused on the M54, Junction 2, West Island Junction 3, Wolverhampton to Old Button, lane closure for roadworks are problem there. Breakdown in for the crew, still causing some delays. This is South and Dutch of Kenflower, hammers for the M54. Two buildings, if there is a breakdown from the on the northbound side, and just after the M5, they get back to normal out of the M11 northbound side, and it's a good bit very busy down there, after the taxi was moved to the side. Problems on the M1 now, still on the coast southbound, just from 12 to 11, getting to the city, but fine accident. Also on the M5, so the other way on the coast clockwise, from junction 23, the A1M, South Mims, to junction 24 at Potter's Barn, accident at length of that one, hence the road journey for this call. Accident's being recovered from the M35, this is at into clockwise before we go into the dark baton, the key's there, are to junction 3, which is the M20. Further problems on the M35. Clockwise, now, if you've been listening in the morning, you'll know that it was blocked for a while, but there's, it has reopened, there's just one lane closed following the car back, junction 10 to 11, entry through the churches. The trouble is, the traffic is taking a very long time to ease off. It's been almost to junction 8 at Ryegate, and anti-clockwise traffic is also slow to the scene. That's better than it was. It's back past junction 12 now, but it's had a knock-on effect to the northbound A4, which has been changed from Ripley. Stranded lorry on the A4 northbound just after the M4 at junction 13. That's blocked along the queues onto the motorway at Chewgate. Hence the Stormbringer and Grace's dad to that one back in the car.
Missed a couple there, then. Every time you say Cheatley, you'll say Cheatley yourself! That used to be in the debate.
When I missed Chorses, yeah.
And Ripley, you've got to say believe it or not. Alistair on Irvine says, I can't believe...